my life was all in order. When they tossed a hand grenade, I thought I might be dreaming,
but you didn't fade.
Now, Shabu.
Sorry I have to do this to you, San Antonio Fats, but it's time to separate the big guns from the pea shooters. Now, I think I'll try this the hard way. Check this.
Hey, what you doing?
Patience, fat man, patience.
Hey, you gotta be kidding, man. Hey, one more game, Shabu. Give me a chance to get even.
I'm sorry, Fats, but I gotta go catch my partner Keith on TV. Thanks for the game. And go easy on the cheesecake.
You students and you parents of students should be watching next when Keith Burrows gives us his report on student loans.
We'll be right back.
Okay, all right. The next story, scratch it. Burrows, give me some room here.
Wait a minute, no, that's my story. That
it'll
I've been
keep,
working
Keith,
on that
it'll
for weeks.
Keep. All right, we'll open on Professor Bob. He'll talk a little bit about the meteor race, then introduce Nelson. Professor Bob, you know what to say.
Yes, ma'am.
Ready in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Folks, at this juncture, I'd like to invite you on down to the beach to catch our annual KPOX Media Invitational 10-kilometer run. You're gonna see all your favorite local news personalities from TV and radio. They'll be out there shaking their celebrity tails for charity. They're all going to be trying to beat this man. Now, he's won it 4 years in a row, and he's our general manager here at KPOX, Nelson Marriott. Very proud to have him with us tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, Nelson Marriott.
Thank you, Professor Bob. I'd just like to remind everyone that the proceeds from this year's media race go to the reconstruction of the pier. Now, at this time, I'd like to present to our media team their official race numbers. Arlene, here's your number. Jim, your number. And Professor Bob.
Thank you, Nelson.
Don't I get a number? I'm in the race, too.
Burrows.
This race is for the biggies. I mean, you Saturday joggers are welcome, but not important. Won't you join us, please, and help save that old wooden warrior, our huckleberry friend, the Vista Beach Pier.
Jim?
That's it for the 6 o'clock edition of the KPOX News. This is Jim Dexter saying, from the freeways to the fault line, to all of Southern California, a pleasant good evening.
Nelson, you were wonderful. Huh? Is it possible to be sensual during a newscast?
What? Oh, yeah.
Can we get together later tonight, or are you, training?
Training? Mm-hmm. Oh, you mean for the race? No, plenty of time for that. I think my place tonight, a little Chinese takeout around the fire. Maybe later we'll play some of my erotic video games. Yes.
Hey,
Hey, buddy, I was watching at home, and Nelson really made you look like an idiot.
Oh, I don't believe that guy. He humiliated me on the air. I would love to beat him in that race and wave that winner's cup right under his smug little mustache.
You can do it. You can make that preppy-looking sleazebag eat your dust.
Oh, I don't know, man. He's probably in pretty good shape.
So what do you care? Don't you understand you are a personal friend of the genie Reno? You're in tight with the imp.
No, I couldn't win with magic. It wouldn't be satisfying. Oh, I want to see Nelson grovel, but I got to do it my own way. I'm vindictive, but I'm fair.
Now, who's talking magic? I'm talking training. Keith, I'm going to be your trainer.
No way, man. My life gets too crazy when you're around.
Oh, now, just hold it. Now, what could possibly go wrong? What if I told you I trained the original Olympic athletes? You know, the ones with the grape leaves in their hair? Did you know those guys ran nude? Yep. In those days, the 100-meter high hurdles really meant something. Hey, come on. Let me be a part of this. Together, you and I can beat this sucker.
Okay. All right.
All right.
All right.
That's my man. Let's go.
Shabu? Shabu, could you get that as Laura? And be nice to her. It took me 6 months to set this date up.
What happened to the train?
Well, I'm gonna train. I'm gonna start first thing in the morning. Just sit with her while I get ready, okay?
Like it or not, you're starting tonight. May I help you?
I'm Laura. I'm supposed to meet Keith here.
Tonight? Are you sure?
Of course. Is there something wrong?
What could be wrong? Come on in.
Make yourself comfortable. I'll be out in a minute.
Okay, Keith.
Any messages for Keith?
Yeah. Tell him this.
Ow! Nice meeting you, too. Thanks, girls.
You're welcome, Shabu. Where's Laura?
Now, Keith, I could lie to you. I could tell you that she was carried away by Fidel Castro, and if I really wanted to, I could tell you that she came down with a rare tropical disease. But look, man, I'm a level with you. I had to get rid of her.
You did what?
Hey, listen, if you want to win this race, you can't be out there all night chasing a beautiful woman. Now, that woman was hot. She could do you some damage.
I know that. Why do you think I was trying to date her? All right, look, let's get one thing very straight. This is my life, my apartment. And that was my date.
Okay, Mr. Hormones, go chase your pretty little friend. Stay out all night. Lose the race. I don't care. Nelson won't care. Go on. Knock your socks off.
You're right. I hate that, but you're right.
Good, because from now on, I'll tell you when to get up and when to go to sleep. Now it's time to hit the sack.
Now? It's only 9 o'clock. No way.
Some inspiration.
Keep on working.
This is Jim Dexter saying, from the freeways to the fault lines, to all of Southern California, a pleasant good evening.
All right, Keith. Hey, listen, I'm gonna take you out for a big spaghetti dinner tonight. Fill you up with carbohydrates, get you ready for the big race.
All right, great. I'll just get out of makeup and I'll meet you in the parking lot.
Okay, you do that.
Okay.
Good right, luck tomorrow.
Thank you, Jim.
Oh, yes. Good luck. Good luck to all of you. You'll need it. And may the best man win. Again. How about it, darling? Tonight at 8 at Minerva's? Hmm? Nice juicy rack of lamb and some Italian vino? Hmm?
Nelson, we have been out to eat every night this week. Now, shouldn't you take it easy the night before the race?
Meagan, don't worry. Got it made. Got it all sewn up. Had it sewn up for the last 4 years. I'm a born champion.
You know what, Nelson? Something stinks around here, and it sure isn't your cologne. I better check this boy out. Ah. So that's your little scam, hey, Nelson? Now that's cold-blooded. I'm glad you're still up. You know, something's on my mind, and it's just been bugging.
Yeah, yeah, okay, okay. But first, I something I wanted to... it's just here.
What is it?
Oh, I just wanted to say thanks, that's all. You know, you've done a lot for me. Now, I know you're used to a lot more extravagant things, but shopping for a genie is tough.
Hey, that's sharp.
I don't know what to say. No one's ever given me anything before. Hey, thanks.
Hey, you earned it. And tomorrow, when I run that race, it's not just for me, it's for us.
We're a team.
Right.
All right. Yeah.
Good night, Coach. Oh, what was it you want to tell me?
Nothing. I can't take care of myself.
Okay. Good night.
Night, buddy. Even sleeps crooked.
Nelson Marriott!
Yo, Nelson, wake up!
Who are you? You're up the creek, Nelson. Let's talk cheating.
What do you want to know?
Put a sock in it, Nelson. This isn't a talk show. Now drag your butt up off that mattress. I gotta warn you, Nelson. I'm not in a good mood. I was scheduled to haunt Diana Ross. But no, I got stuck with you, Mr. Scuzzball. Now check this out. Here comes a blast from the past. You were tin, tiny, and twerpy. Look familiar?
Oh. Yes, that's Camp Cayuga. That good-looking kid? That's me, winning the potato race.
You won, Nelson.
But let's see how.
You cheated, Nelson. It was a black day in potato racing.
Oh, but you don't understand, Spirit. I was under a lot of pressure. I mean, my dad said to me, he said, Nelson, you win that race. You're a Marriott. Marriotts are superior to every living thing. I had to win.
Yeah, by cheating.
One time.
Give me a break. I bet you remember this night.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the night I won the middleweight intercollegiate boxing championship.
You won?
Yeah. Knocked him out in the third round with a right hook.
Before the fight, your left was active too. You bought him out with $300 in the hallway. Nelson Marriott cheats again.
I didn't cheat. I rigged.
What's the difference?
Rigging costs big bucks.
You're a slime, Nelson. When I get through with you, I have to get this shroud dry clean. Check this out.
Excuse me, Spirit, but I don't recognize this.
How could you, Double? It hasn't happened yet.
And now for this year's winner, Nelson Marriott.
My mother's operation. I could have been a contender.
Nelson Marriott dyes his hair.
He promised me a raise I never got. He's a liar.
Liar, liar, pants on fire.
Hold, everybody. Hey, come on. Now, this is America. Give the man a chance.
Look. Burrows is helping me.
Keith Burrows is a prince. He deserves a big raise.
I promise, Mila, I'll never cheat again. I promise I'll never cheat again. I'll never cheat again. I'm a Marriott. No, I won't cheat.
Good luck.
All right.
I know you're going to do it.
Thanks.
Stay loose.
All right.
All right.
Oh, I don't care what I promised. I got it, Chief.
Runners, get into position. For 30. Positions, runners.
Thank you.
boy pulling off an amazing upset in this year's Media 10K. All right!
Thanks again, man. This is the best day of my life.
Hey, well, what can I say? Any good genie would have done the same. Make that any good friend.
I still can't figure out what happened to Nelson.
Where am I? Obviously not Beverly Hills. Sorry, no problem.
Your street?
Fine, Long Street. I'll just be leaving. I'll just be going.
Meagan? Meagan!